Good morning. Today, I'm going to present on social group, its characteristics, classification, and its function in a nutshell. Before going to further details, we should say that human beings are part of social group. A social group exists when two or more people are in direct or indirect contact or communication. When we attend music concert, when we are attending seminar, workshop, we are the part of social group. We may use the term group to mean such group as age group, sex group, family group, religious group, and so on. Now, we should discuss about the difference of social aggregate and societal group. What is societal group? What is an aggregate? First we discuss. An aggregate is a gathering of persons. We have come together temporarily and lack of any meaningful social interaction. Suppose on a road an accident took place. The people gathered there and Mr. A is saying that what an incident took place, and someone is saying, oh, this is the fault of a bus driver. That means they are not directly communicating each other, but they are throwing some observations of amongst them. So these groups are called social aggregate. As an example, we may say a crowd, passengers on a bus, mob are all an aggregate. Whereas a societal group is a collectivity of persons who share certain common values and interests and have some feeling of solidarity. For example, caste, religious group, nationality group, etc. Now, with these views, we are moving towards the definition of social group. A social group is a plurality of persons who have a common identity, at least some feeling of unity, certain common goals and shared norm, and fairly high level of interaction. So, the definition of social group says the social, meaningful social interaction. For example, family, peer groups, your sociology class, etc. We are now discussing some of the definition about the sociologist who was saying about social group. McIver and Page define social group as any collection of human beings who are brought into human relationship with one another. S. Bogardus defines social group as a number of persons, two or more, who have common objects of attention, who are stimulating to each other, who have common loyalty and participate in similar activities. So in this definition, we can see that the number of persons is very necessary and they have some common objects of attention and they have some common loyalty and participate in the similar activities. With these definition, keeping in mind, we are now going to the characteristics of social group. So, we are now defining the first characteristics, which is collection of individuals. Social group consists of people. Without individuals, there can be no group. Just like without a teacher, we cannot have a college, classroom, university, etc. The second one, interaction among members. Social interaction is the very basis of group life. The members must have interact between them, otherwise social group cannot be consist. Number three, mutual awareness. Group life involves mutual awareness. Group members are aware of one another, and their behavior is determined by this mutual recognition. And the next one is we feeling. We feeling are the tendency on the part of the members to identify themselves within the group, so that the member identify themselves, that is their group. The next one is group unity and solidarity. Group members are tied by a sense of unity. The solidarity or integration of a group is largely dependent upon the frequency, variety, and the emotional quality of the interaction of its members. The next, we move on to common interest. The interest and the ideals of the group are very common. Group are mostly formed or established for some certain interests. Suppose in a group that is constituted for a special purpose, say Red Cross, they have specific interest. For these interests, the members constituted the group. Similar behavior is another important characteristic of social group. The members of the group behave more or less in a similar way for the pursuit of common interests. We must say that social group represents the collective behavior. The next, group norms. Every group has its own rules or norms which the members are supposed to follow. These norms may be in the form of folkways, customs, mores, laws, etc. Next, size of the group is very, very important characteristics. Every group has its own size. A group may be small, suppose a family, a nuclear family rather, we may say. And their nuclear family, you know, that there is husband and wife and their offsprings. Obviously, the size is very small. But when we see the joint family, obviously the size is very large. So the size of the group is very large. Stability. Group may be stable or unstable, permanent or temporary in character. Likewise, as we said earlier, the crowd, it's temporary or unstable, whereas the family is permanent and stable. Now, I'm moving towards the classification of social group. But before going to classification, we should know the criteria of the classification of group. There are various factors of classifying the group, such as racial features, territory, castes, sex, age, occupation, nature of social interaction, and degree of social mobility. The first group I should mention, in-group and out-group. W.J. Sumner made distinction between in-group and out-group on the basis of individual identities. First, I should mention in-groups are the group in which individual identify himself or his own group. That means we can say that we belong to this group. Suppose you, the first year of sociology department, you say that we are the student of first year. So we are the members of the, we are the members of our in-group. And whenever you are saying about your professors, that they are our professors. So that is your out-group. Vice versa, whenever we are saying, the professors are saying, we the professors and they are the students, then we are the in-group and you are the out-group. The next one is primary and secondary group. On the basis of natural contact of the group, C.H. Cooley classified social group into two, where the nature of interaction is very common, direct, and the size of the group is small, it may be termed as primary group. The two features is very important. Interaction is very common and direct. Obviously, the interaction will be direct whenever the size of the group will be small. For example, family, your classmate, etc. Whereas in secondary group, the relationships are indirect, impersonal, and normally the size is very large. For example, factory workers, members of political parties, etc. The needs group. German sociologist George Simmel, or Simmel, whatever you may say, considered size as a criteria for classifying group. Earlier, I mentioned the nature of interaction. Now I'm mentioning the size of the group. In a smaller group, he began with nomad group, where one person is the center of group relations. Likewise, in a class, teacher is the center of the group. He then perceived to the group as dyad, between two, likewise husband and wife, and the triad, husband, wife, and their offsprings. On the other hand, large groups are racial and political groups. Dewitt Sanderson classified group into threefold by structure: involuntary, which is based on kinship; voluntary, the person joins groups on his own volition or wish; delegate groups, person joins as the representative of number of people. The next classification is horizontal and vertical group. Peterim Sorokin terms social group on the basis of social mobility as horizontal and vertical. Horizontal group is large in size, inclusive, and characterized by similar status. For example, labor union, political parties, etc. Whereas in vertical group, there are smaller divisions, economic classes, and unequal status, etc. For example, we may say in a factory, there are managing director, manager, senior officer, sub-staffs, and the laborers in a factory. The next classification is Gemeinschaft and Gesellschaft. The famous German sociologist Tonnies has taken interaction as the basis of a classification of groups as Gemeinschaft and Gesellschaft, which is very much related to primary and secondary group. Gemeinschaft signifying a close knit community where the social relationships are personal and informal. Whereas the Gesellschaft refers to secondary group where the relationships are formal, as seen in the industrialized urban society. Groups may be classified as open and closed also. Some groups apply rigidity in membership are closed group. For example, caste group. People born into it and they cannot change their caste. And whereas some are flexible in accepting new members, they are open group like class. The next classification is done by Robert K. Martin into totalitarian and segmentary. The totalitarian groups, like the family or village, which satisfy all the needs of a society, like family. So people are satisfied their basic needs into the society, into the family. Whereas the segmentary groups, like religious organization, which satisfy limited needs of the members. The next classification is organized and unorganized group. Social groups have been classified on the basis of their degree of organization into organized groups and unorganized groups. Organized groups are established purposefully for the fulfillment of some specific interests. These groups are often called associational groups. Here, the social interaction among the members is systematic, orderly, and patterned. Hence, the behavior is predictable. For example, we can say about trade unions, political parties, religious organizations, etc. Whereas, social group that conspicuously lack the attribute of organization can be called unorganized groups. They do not have any well-defined pattern of interaction. It is characterized by unpredictability, indefiniteness, and uncertainty. Definite social norms may not be observed. For example, crowd, mobs, etc. Spatial group. The spatial groups are those which are constituted because of spatial continuity of their members. Such groups are clan, tribe, and band. Now, what is clan? A clan is a group of individuals who consider themselves the common descendants of real or mythical ancestors. For example, Varad, Devaj, Gautam in Indian system. For example, from Gautam, the caste Kshatriya, or the surname Basu. From Vishwamitra, the surname Mitra's king. Tribe. According to George Marduk, tribe is a social group in which there are many clans, nomadic bands, villages, or other subgroups that usually have a definite geographical area, a separate language, a distinctive culture. So three important features is necessary for tribe, that is definite geographical territory, definite language or specific language, and a distinct culture. For example, Santal, Vil, Orao, etc. Now, reference group. The term reference group was introduced into the literature on small groups by Muzaffar Sherif in his book, An Outline of Social Psychology. According to Akban and Nemkov, groups which serve as a points of comparison are known as reference group. The concept of reference group arises essentially from the fact that any person acting in any situation may be influenced not only by his membership group, but also by his conception of other group of which he is not a member. These other groups exert their influence as reference group in a purely a passive or silent way. Suppose sometimes whenever in the class I'm saying, oh, see, you, the first year student, are not coming regularly on classes. You are not attending. See, the second year students come regularly, used to come regularly, they follow the class notes, classes. So I'm referring the second year students to you. So the students of second year is a reference group to you. Now I'm mentioning about the functions of social group in a nutshell. The first is socializing agency. The group is an agency of socialization or enculturation. As a result of social interaction, we learn various traits and we are made human. Cradle of habit system, the second functions. Our habits are formed in the group, and by virtue of our habituation to the modes of life prevalent in the group, we tend to think that they are the best. The third is emotional security and satisfaction. every group is characterized by varying degrees of emotional solidarity. It also acts as an agency that satisfied some of the needs of the members. And the fourth one is stimulation of activity. Group life stimulates activity among the members. In a group, people act more efficiently than they would if they are alone. The status of a person in the group is dependent on his efficiency, and there is an efficient system of rewards and punishment. So, we discussed about the classification, characteristics, criteria of classification, and functions of social group. So, that's all for today. Thank you.